There was a hodgepodge of activity at the state capitol this past week, but the big deadline centered around filing proposals for potential constitutional amendments. Bradley Phillips with Lobby Up now joins us for our weekly fill of stats and analysis. Always good to have you with us. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Roby. Great to be here.
Let's talk about the first most popular bill of the week. It dealt with PARC testing, which some people may not even know what PARC testing is.
PARC is a standard testing that would be something akin to the MAT-6 or something that we took. And with this bill is it eliminates the PARC test. Well, the problem is with that, the PARC test is in about 3 or 4 weeks, and students and teachers have been preparing for it, and the state's already purchased that. So
to the tune of
$30
million. $30 million. You're just going to flush it down the drain?
There's going to be some amendments. There's some problems with the language, and hopefully they'll get that fixed.
Let's see if that bill makes it through in time for it to not apply to this year. Is it set up to do that?
Yes, it's got an emergency clause. So, yeah. And it also is connected to Common Core, so that adds a certain heat to the bill.
How many unique visitors did that bill get this week?
That bill got 300 or 400 unique visitors.
Let's go to another bill that would end, it wouldn't end the private option because they've already passed that, signed that into law. This would be a notification to people that the private option is ended.
It would notify people when they enrolled or re-enrolled that the ending date would be December 31st of 2016. Now, interesting, what if it continues and this bill passes? So you're notifying people that it's ending, but it's not ending.
That's the sausage making process of the Arkansas General Assembly. All right, another bill that was definitely stirred a lot of traffic this past week, and it is bound to stir up more traffic, deals with hands-free devices in cars. Representative David Fielding from Magnolia has got an idea to do what?
Well, I've read the bill over and over, and I truly believe that it prohibits any use of your cell phone in the car, hands-free or not. And so it takes in some new definitions. So I don't think you could talk to Siri or, you know, do any of those things that we normally do in our cars hands-free if this bill passes. Now, I may be wrong, but that's the way I read it.
Yeah, well, that's questions bound to get raised in a committee hearing when somebody asks for a little bit more detail about that. All right, we talked about constitutional amendments. The deadline to file proposed constitutional amendments was this week. There were almost 40 potential or possible constitutional amendments. They can only refer three to the voters. So there's going to be a lot of negotiating and weeding out. So none of these have necessarily a great shot of being put into place, but something's going to rise to the top. What's your favorite one? Is it to do away with the lieutenant governor's office?
I think that would be the most interesting one. I can't say that it's my favorite one. Representative Mayberry has three. Two of them do away with the office, but the interesting one mandates that basically the governor and lieutenant governor run as a ticket, and that governor candidate must announce his running mate 60 days before the primary.
Oh, interesting. So we'll see where that one goes. Also, another one to make sheriff's terms, which are currently 2 years, into 4-year terms. The counties have fought for extended terms for county officials for a long time. This one's just specifically on county sheriffs.
It's just for county sheriffs. You know, all judges, treasurers, assessors, they'd love to be extended to 4 years. Like congressmen and House of Reps, they're always running for office. And so I think that if a sheriff stayed in office for 4 years, it would provide a little bit of stability and help long-term planning for the jails.
Well, the sausage-making process that we referred to earlier and to how these constitutional amendments even get referred is a fascinating theory. We'll watch that as it plays out. Bradley Phillips with Lobby Up, thank you so much for being with us this morning. As always, great stuff.
Good to see you.